The countdown is on February 3rd to 6th. Scotiabank Hockey Day in Canada is coming right here to Kamloops, and Sean is joining us on the show. Thanks for coming.
Happy to be here.
Our pleasure to have you. Talk a little bit about what this event is going to look like. All eyes are going to be on Kamloops and hockey.
Yeah, you know, it's a four-day event that we're going to be celebrating hockey in Kamloops and right across Canada, showing them what we have to offer here, both in hockey and community involvement. There's opening ceremonies taking place at Sun Peaks Resort on Wednesday, February 3rd, moving right through to Hockey Day, which is Saturday, February 6th, and lots of events in between.
Yeah, lots of events and lots of excitement. You're going to have some big names here. There's going to be a broadcast that's nationally seen. Tell us a little bit about that side of things.
There's probably 12 to 15 pretty famous names, well-known celebrities and ex-NHL players that'll be here in town attending the luncheon that takes place up at the Tournament Capital Center on February the 4th, right through to the alumni game, which happens here at Sandman Center on Thursday evening at 7:30.
Cool. For the average family, the average hockey lover at home here in Kamloops, how can they partake in some of the festivities or the energy in town?
We've priced a lot of the events to be family affordable. The Music of Hockey concert, which takes place Friday night here at Sandman Center at 7:30, all tickets are $5. And that's going to be basically a variety musical show with several different entertainers, again, NHL stars and celebrities getting on stage in between sets and songs and interacting with the crowd. And the Stanley Cup will even be in attendance. So, you know, we've priced that to be affordable for the family. The 50th season WHL Pro-Am game Thursday night is also priced affordably, $10 for adults, $5 for kids, those prices plus taxes. But you know, our main objective is to make this accessible for everybody in town at an affordable price. And you know, there are lots of other activities where the Stanley Cup will be out and about in the public at private events, at school visits and hockey clinics, but lots of that stuff's being scheduled.
Yeah. This is only the second time that Hockey Day in Canada has been in British Columbia.
That's right.
I think it was in Nelson in 2007 or something. So what does it mean to people here in Kamloops to have all eyes, like I said, on our city?
You know, they've called it a six-hour commercial for Kamloops on TV, and that's going, like I say, across Canada and North America. I think they have about 10 million hits on social media and between Facebook and Twitter and TV broadcasting. We're reaching a wide variety of people, just again showing what Kamloops has to offer in our facilities, in our volunteers, and in our just our community in general. And I think everybody's going to come out to support it, and that's what we're hoping.
Mm-hmm. On that note, maybe do you think Kamloops holds anything in particular that's special or sets them apart from other communities as far as hockey goes?
You know, I think hockey is pretty special to a lot of communities across Canada, so I don't want to say that we're any better at it than anybody else, but, you know, just the fact that we've had such success with the Kamloops Blazers through the 90s and some of those players and coaches that have gone on to better careers in the National Hockey League says something about, you know, something going right in Kamloops for hockey.
Something in our water.
Yeah, that's right. Cool. Yeah.
Thanks for coming on the show, Sean. We're going to chat with Sean coming up a little bit later as well, and we're going to chat with Jim. But first, we stop by a local fitness studio to find out how they're raising the bar here in the community. Hey, and welcome back to this week's episode of Go. We're here outside the Sandman Center talking about Hockey Day in Canada coming, of course, February 3rd through 6th. Some big names and lots of events here to take part in. Jim joining us now. He's chair of the event. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you for having us.
My pleasure. I like your jacket there. That's some nice logo there. So what are you looking forward to with regard to this event?
Well, mainly to get the community involvement and get them out here and see what we can put on. And it's actually quite a show. It's going to be like starting at Sun Peaks on Wednesday night right through to Saturday. The street's going to be closed off over here for the road hockey tournament. Mm-hmm. There's going to be a stage here. There's going to be live entertainment Saturday. There's going to be a hot stove going on Saturday with Darcy Tucker, Mark Recchi, guys like that around. So, yeah, it's going to be a good event.
Yeah. An opportunity to show off and showcase Kamloops, but also showcase hockey. You've got a long history with hockey in many forms in Kamloops. Talk a little bit about your involvement in the past years.
Well, I've been involved for years since when my boys were kids, and I was involved as a director of minor hockey for some 10 or 12 years, and I was president for 3.5 years. And so I've been involved with hockey, and then I've been with a group of old guys that have been together, some of us, for 25 years, and we're still together, the Free Radicals of all names. But, yeah, it's a good group of guys, and so we stay, all of us stay involved. We've got 7 or 8 of them involved with our committee, as a matter of fact.
Wow. So you guys have probably spent many weeks, months planning this event. What do you think people are going to really take away from this? Is it the big names, or are they going to take away a real sense of hockey, the heart of hockey from the community?
Well, I think they will. It's always good to have the big names along, because that'll bring the people out. But they'll see the spirit of hockey. And this year's theme is teamwork. And right from our committee on, it's taken a team to put this thing together. And so they'll see the teamwork, and then evolve just with the event as it's coming together.
Yeah, cool. Thanks for coming on the show, Jim.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for having
me. Our pleasure. And up next, the Kamloops Luxury Bridal Fair is happening again at TRU on January 31st. And our Fred Semenik took a look at some new trends for this year's show. The Sandman Center, as well as the TCC and up at Sun Peaks, are going to play host to some events from February 3rd through 6th for Scotiabank Hockey Day in Canada. It's kind of a mouthful, but we're here with Sean again. He's joining us on the show to tell us more. Sean, if someone wants more information, they want to find a schedule of events, how do they do so?
We've got lots of information on our website, which is www.kamloops.ca/hockeyday. And there you'll find information on the ticketed events and all the other events and where it's going to be and when. Throughout the week.
Perfect. We'll throw those links on the bottom of the screen as well. Last question, what are you looking forward to most? Is there anything that you're really excited about, or just kind of the whole thing as a whole?
You know, I'm looking forward to everybody coming out on Saturday to the Outdoor Festival. I mean, to all the events, of course, throughout the week, but particularly Saturday when we've got all the activities going on down here and Kamloops is on the stage for North America to see. That's what I'm hoping to see.
Thanks again for coming on the show, Sean.
Pleasure.
That is it for this week's episode of Go. Thank you so much for watching. As I mentioned before, we're going to throw some more information on the screen again if you'd like a schedule of events or just want to find out what exactly is going down for Scotiabank Hockey Day in Canada, again happening February 3rd through the 6th. We as well are on social media, online at Shaw TV Kamloops on Facebook, Twitter, and newly to Instagram, so we'd love to hear from you there. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.